SEHER has carried out several fact-finding missions in South Asia, and our emphasis has been also to include smaller countries. So we have had a fact-finding mission on the Bhutanese refugees, a fact-finding mission in the Maldives on what is happening there to human rights and to democracy.
How many people in this country jump to have a green card? So we shouldn't be surprised if there is a whole generation of Bhutanese who want this option, want this out. Why rot in these refugee camps that do nothing for you, that don't even give you the right to earn a living or anything like that?
The camps where they have been kept are now too small. Lots of people have come. Their living conditions are bad. The allowance given to them is very limited. And the UN representatives whom we met, they said, look here, they cannot bear more expense. Similarly, Nepal government said they must leave because they are already a burden on their economy. So what do they? So their conditions are very pitiable.
Bhutanese refugee problem in Nepal is a problem that has been there for the last 17 years. And this problem is not a Nepali problem. It's a problem about a group of people, a whole community of Bhutanese population, who by virtue of the fact that they happen to speak one particular language, that they happen to follow one particular religion, were virtually, and because they demanded their civil liberties, their cultural rights, their social rights, were virtually kicked out of the country by the Bhutanese regime many years ago.
The pathetic part is that the refugees were for the last 18 years demanding for repatriation, and that was why the 15th round of the process came, bilateral talk came, but In view of Bhutan's reluctance, the third country resettlement has taken up. And meanwhile, to further prolong the process, Bhutan government has to also at the same time shy away from the world community and the international eyes, declared a kind of a democracy which we call it pseudo and farce.